Yeah, it's Huffle, it's Double H. It's been a long time, but I'm here for the official review for Tinker Tailor Tuki Taka, or rather Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy. I pretty much got straight back from this flick, you know, so I'm releasing a fresh, full-on review. And as you can see, my head has been pretty much twisted. This is a tricky one, because there are many elements here, and I wanted to do a non-spoiler review, and I might do a non-spoiler review, but I first want to just get into this spoiler review. This, I repeat, is a spoiler review. Please. So, I may do a non-spoiler review for my American friends who only get this film on December 9th, but this is a spoiler review. This film could either be one of the craziest and best spy films that has ever been made and I've ever seen, or it could be just a pretty damn good spy film. And again, I repeat, this all goes down to spoilers. And remember, guys, this is spoiler territory now, because I've been thinking about this all the way back down. The film ended with Colin Firth's character being the spy. So we had Gary Oldman, who, you know, his George Smiley, who basically found out that Hayden, aka Colin Firth, was the spy. And for me, I was like, you know, the film was pretty crazy all the way leading up to there, and like there were some tense moments, just how everything was built up, and just the intricacy and the complexity of the story was just so amazing. I was like, wow. You know, I mean, I was like, wow, this is pretty crazy, you know. And then it sort of just, you know, I just felt that, you know, that ending felt like a bit of an anti-climax, you know. When I walked out to the cinema, I was like, okay, you know, yes, it's a very well-made film, some, you know, very, very good performances. Gary Oldman, I'll get to that guy there. But I said, yeah, you know, very well-made film, very well-directed and everything like that, you know. But, you know, I just felt that, is that it? Is that it? Okay, Colin Firth was the spy, was a mole, Gary Oldman saved the day, thank you, Baba is now the head of the circus or whatever the place is called. But then as I walked through and I played back the film to myself, then I began to think about, who was Carla? Then I began to think about that, I'm forgetting his name, I think it's Polyakov or something, you know, why Gary Oldman was in the room with that Polyakov guy. Then I began to think of you know, the whole thing of, like, you know, Gary Oldman's character, the George Smiley character. And then I thought about when our dear friend John Hurt was basically aka Control was basically naming the different people for the Max Wrong character, I think it was Predo or something like that, you know Tinker Tailor, you know, all of the people that were within the circles, I, you know, the Toby Jones, Colin Firth, Sierra Hines, all the people that were, you know, within that place there. And then, you know, he didn't see the last person who was actually spy. And obviously that spy person was Gary Oldman. So I thought about all these different elements. Because obviously the natural thing that we see in many films is that, okay, oh wow, you know, Gary Oldman was a spy and it's all revealed, and like there's a big massive twist. But then I thought to myself that maybe this film is working on a whole other level. And Gary Oldman really is the spy. And then I also thought about his lighter. You know that he got from his wife. Then I thought about his wife and him seeing his wife again, the woman who supposedly cheated with Colin Firth. Then I thought about all these elements, then I thought about, man, maybe this guy is like a crazy spy, fully deep cover, who planned this whole thing. And now being the head of the circus, now this guy is now fully in deep. And if that is true, this film is a damn crazy film. If that is, and that's my theory. Again, I've been on the IMDb boards, and a guy put forth that theory, and it was thrown out, and guy says, oh, no, sorry, that's not wrong. So maybe I'm wrong. But if I'm wrong, then, you know, the film, you know, it's an 8 out of 10. It's still a good film. But if my theory is right that Gary Oldman is a spy who is not told to us, as in it's not spoon-fed to us, we have to actually work it out that he really is a spy that nobody found out. And he's still fully in there. This film's crazy. That's all I'm saying, bro. But looking at the film, man, this was a very well-made film. So whether that was the ending or not, this was a quality movie. Without doubt, this is the best film I've seen this year. I mean, it's like, you know, people have said that, okay, it's boring, it's very slow. Spies, the way spies walk properly is not like James Bond. I'm sorry. It's not these shooting guys with, like, you know, massive explosions and, you know, thank you, sir, cocktail, you know, martini, you know, stick, you know, step. No, it's not. That's not how the way spies, I believe, would work is how you saw it in this film. As in, there's hardly any shooting or any explosions. Or not. It's a psychological game. You know, it's a psychological, it's like chess. Hence, well, that was actually a very good metaphor. Like, you know, John Hurt having all of the different people as chess pieces, because that's what the whole spy game, I believe, is about. That it's really about chess. It's a mind game between people. You know, you're really just trying to feel it, each other psychologically. You know, hence that's what makes it interesting. You know, but it's like, you know, so just the way they, you know, the tone of the film, as in aspect one, it was very slow. You know, it wasn't all flashy and all lights and effects. It was very serious and very slow, and it's really, you know, again, it did not spoon feed the audience. You know, you really had to, because like the key thing, it wasn't cheap. That's not, because again, you know, you see so many of these spy films where like they're just trying to cheapen you with special effects, with action pieces, with car chases, all this stuff. But no, this was just very much about dialogue. And again, I say this, everybody. This is a review on my first viewing. This is a first viewing review. So with these kinds of films, you need to see it 2, 3, 4 times, because I'm sure there will be a lot of things that I missed. I believe that I got quite a few things the first time through, but I know for a fact that I always miss stuff the first way through. Because first viewing is always just filling stuff through. But then again, you know, from what I saw, man, look, man, this was, you know, as I think Wake Up said it first, like, you know, this is like a proper spy film. You know, it was a proper spy film. But people would say it was boring. I can understand why people would say it was boring. But, you know, I would, for those that say it was boring, I say, you know what, this is just how it is in the spy game, yo. You know, I believe that this is just how it will be in a spy game. So, you know what I'm saying? But let's talk about that. I mean, the main thing now is, you know, Gary Oldman. I mean, he probably won't get an Oscar or a BAFTA for this. He probably won't even get nominated, which would be a farce. But again, he proved that this is what is the zenith of acting. You know, this is the very precipice of what acting is about, in my view. Because when I was watching this, I was like, yeah, but yeah, you know, that's Colin Firth doing a great job. That's Ciaran Hines doing a great job. That's Toby Jones doing a great job. That's Tom Hardy, who was, for my thought, Tom Hardy was really good in this. Again, the guy's really up on comics. Again, Tom Hardy, really good. That Cumberbatch Thatch guy was good. But you all knew these guys. But again, it's like, with Gary Oldman, you almost felt like, oh, yeah, it's just that guy. You did not feel that Gary Oldman, the actor, was acting. You just felt like if there's just a guy called George Smiley who's there. So you forget that he's acting. That is just, what's the brilliance of his performance, that you don't realize that he's acting. He doesn't let you know that he's acting, because he just, like, for like the first 10 minutes, he doesn't say a single word for like the first 10 minutes. And even by that, you already get a feel for his character when he says zilch, he says nothing. And you're already saying that, man, this guy, you know, I don't know, man. I don't know how to feel about this guy. Because for me, like, I believe that the best acting he did was when he just said nothing, when it was all about his eyes. And you might think that, is this guy good? Is this guy a spy? Is this guy working on something? So there was just so many levels where I was like, what is this guy up to? Because I didn't trust him. You know, I don't care what this was. I didn't, from when I was just following for those first times, I did not trust this guy. It's like, this guy just seems a bit too tricky. He just seems a bit, like, if you don't know, it's a bit too much. And again, you know, when you just saw the way this guy was just slowly finding out the mole, you know, and how he was questioning people, you were like, man, it's like, this guy, again, that was just the brilliance of the performance, was that he did not give you a definitive kind of persona of like of how you should feel about this guy. He wasn't like, no, okay, George Smiley is like, it's open to many interpretations. Hence why I say that I don't care what anybody says. I don't even care what the author tells me. I believe he's a spy. From what I saw of his performance and what Gary Oldman and how he presented George Smiley, I believe this guy's a spy. You know, that's just, that is my sixth sense working, based on how my sixth sense feels about how this guy was. I was like, man, the way he's just delivering the lines, the way his character approached, like, man, I don't know about this guy, man. You know, so for me, I just like, man, this, if you want to just see acting at its very best, where it's not about, oh, come see me, here's my Oscar, where it's like, you know, where nobody's crying or just shouting like that. And when you just see when a guy nails the F out of a character, freaking watch this film. You know, I mean, it's an amazing acting performance that you don't realize it's amazing until you see the film multiple times and you then think that, wait a minute, you know, a guy's actually acting here. That he isn't actually George Smiley. This is just Gary Oldman from bloody West Ham, you know. But this is, you know, that's what I'm saying. But man, from everybody, the acting across the board was good. John Hurt was good. John Hurt, that guy was good. I mean, everybody was good. Everybody was good. You know, everybody was good. You know, and even Ciarán Hinds, the guy, I mean, he hardly had that much of a role, but this was why, you know, you have to always get good actors, because great quality actors, even if you give them like a line, you know, they do that line well and it fits into the bigger picture of the whole thing, no matter how small or how big it is, you know. Always, so the quality actors, they deliver their egg in the board, they all brought their egg into it, you know. And Colin Firth was good, everybody was good. But I think, yeah, man, it's like are there any, like, I can't really think of any bad points about this film. I mean, like, the only bad point I will say about this film is if that's the end of the story, i.e., like, you know, Colin Firth was the guy and Gary Oldman found him out and that was it. So, because if that was just like, okay, yeah, and yeah, it's all good, it's well made, all that kind of stuff. But if that's just the be all and end all of the film, then it's like, you know, whatever. But because, like, if the film is really deep and my theory that's, you know, just Smiley is a damn spy, then it's like, I don't really have a bad thing to say about this film. You know? Because, like, just the way the story was done, how complex the story was, and how it slowly expanded. Like, you know, when you're just finding out, okay, he's trying to find the mole, he's, you know, picking his men, and then when the Tom Hardy character gets represented, when he now fits in his story, and then how you now learn about, you know, the Toby Jones character, and how you learn about Mark Strong's backstory. Like, there's just so many elements being brought in, you know. And for guys who find it boring, okay, cheers, you know. But for me, like, I was pretty much hooked, like, throughout. I mean, there was never a point where I was like, okay, I was bored, because, like, I was like, man, I want to find out what the hell is going on. As in, who is this, who is Carla? You know, who are these Russian guys? And how are the Russian guys mixed up with these British guys? And who are these American guys? You know, what's this operation? Which ones? You know, so there was just so many elements in here. And it's like, you know, adaptations of novels I always had, you know, and I've not read the book. But looking at that film, okay, you can tell whether a film is a good film or a bad film, okay. I don't know what's in that book, but for me, the film that I watched, that's a quality film. That's a real quality movie. You know, and I believe that the film will get a brilliant mark from me, an extremely high mark from me, if Gary Oldman is really the spy in this. I believe that he is, from what I've seen. And those elements that I said that I believe that this guy's a spy. So, bottom line, watch this film. Watch this film, and what word of advice, this is a double-edged word of advice. you have to invest in this film. It's not James Bond. It's not Bond Identity. It's not a cheap Hollywood film. Okay, this film is by Canal Plus, like French guys. So this is a proper movie where if you come in, you come in quiet. You don't bring in popcorn. You come in to fully bring your concentration hats on and concentrate. You know, because you need to listen. You need to be fully attentive throughout the whole entire film. Okay? You need to be fully attentive throughout the whole entire film. You know? So, yeah, man, you know, that is pretty much it, you know, for me. It's a big-time recommendation for me. And again, if it was me giving out the awards, Gary Oldman gets the best actor. I don't give a damn what else comes out this year. That's the best acting performance you're going to see this year. That's the best acting performance you're going to see for many, many, many years, okay? For me, that's what acting's about. Okay, he brought his A-game. Gio did his thing, you know. So, yeah, man, Tinker Tailor Soldier Spy, man. 2 thumbs up from me, man. That's a quality film. That's a very quality film, and I highly, highly recommend it.